Under pressure from Washington, Israel released at least 80 Palestinian prisoners on October 1st. The release followed the announcement of a Mideast peace conference between Israeli Prime Minister Olmert and Palestinian President Abu Mazen. The conference is scheduled for the end of November. Excluded from the talks are Hamas, the Islamist resistance movement now in control of the Gaza Strip, and bitter rivals of President Abu Mazen's Fatah movement. The Real News spoke to Gaza-based journalist Tigreed Al-Khadari.
The U.S. Sponsored Middle East peace conference scheduled end of November means nothing to Hamas right now. What Hamas is doing right now is maintaining with the strategy wait and see. They are sure that it will lead to a failure, that Israel will give nothing to Abu Mazen, the president of the Palestinian Authority, and therefore this is the position they are taking. Just wait and see, wait for the end of this conference, and then they know that Abu Mazen, by the failure, he will come back to them and he will seek a dialogue between Fatah and Hamas. What Israel did was releasing a few prisoners, more than 80. The number is not that huge, but they released them due to a pressure by the U.S. administration in preparation for the Middle East peace conference scheduled end of November. Does it mean a goodwill gesture to bolster Abu Mazen? So far, it hasn't proved so. It was one-day story, a story in the West Bank when they released a few numbers, and another story, another day story in Gaza, but it hasn't done anything to improve the image of Abu Mazen in the street. The Gazans feel very angry at Abu Mazen for abandoning them, for leaving them alone, for asking policemen not to work and to leave the security forces in the hand of Hamas by itself.
On September 19th, Israel's security cabinet declared the Gaza Strip a hostile entity in response to rockets fired at southern Israel. These incidents have presented Hamas with a host of challenges.
The recent rockets that were fired towards Israel meant a lot to Hamas. It's a huge challenge to Hamas. Who is firing are groups like Islamic Jihad and Al-Aqsa Brigades, the military wing of Fatah, and small other groups. Hamas cannot say it loud, stop the rockets. It's not serving our cause. What Hamas is dying to achieve is to maintain calm, to have a mutual truce with the Israelis in order for Israel to open the crossings. These small groups like Islamic Jihad and Al-Aqsa make it hard for Hamas to reach such a truce with Israel. They keep firing these rockets at war Israel, and their main concern to make it hard for Hamas. They don't want Hamas to succeed in Gaza. Not only Israel doesn't want Hamas to succeed, but also these small groups. Hamas is in a trap. They are a resistance movement, but at the same time, they decide to get into politics. Now they find it very hard to say it loud and clear that we are against firing the rockets. Beside the crossings and the closure of the Gaza Strip and the closure of Hamas from the whole world, Hamas is confronted by another challenge, which is achieving internal security in order to gain public support. They've been promising people that this is what they are aiming to do, is achieving internal security. Now they are in full control of Gaza. Have they succeeded? So far they have not. This is the first time that they are getting into such sector, which is police. The challenge is how to transfer fighters into policemen. They have no training, they have no human rights training, and that's a very challenging for Hamas to prove itself, to respect other people's choice, to respect freedoms, freedom of religion, freedom of speech.
According to Al-Khadari, daily life in Gaza is grim. All border crossings are closed. Only the most basic food and medicines are allowed in. And patience among local residents is wearing thin.
People in Gaza are very frustrated. They are losing hope completely. They are living in jail. They cannot move around. I just met 20 students who got a Fulbright scholarship, and they cannot leave outside. They are not able to go to Jerusalem and apply for an American visa. So there is a frustration among different sectors in the Palestinian society. Sick people cannot leave Gaza. The closure is getting more severe. Before, Rafah used to be open. Now it's closed completely. And there are no other exits for the Gazans. So they are in a trap, they are in jail, and this humanitarian situation has been deteriorating on a daily basis. I asked someone, how do you describe the situation today? How do you find Gaza today? He said, today is much better than tomorrow.